If you look at beach-oriented societies such as California or Australia, the incidence of this disease is, or the reported incidence is much higher than in the UK, where, you know, people don't go to the beach very much. But actually, it is incredibly common, and most patients come to me after they've seen their GP for a number of years, and they were really, really desperate. Some of them are bullied at schools, and they all been told, "Oh, don't worry, you're gonna grow out of it." Well, in fact, you're not gonna grow out of it. If anything, it's gonna get worse as you grow up. So, and now also, most recent guidelines recommend treatment of this condition as soon as possible, because apart from the cosmetic element of it, there is also a kind of a problem with breathing and heart function. So the minute you restore the normal geometry of the chest, the heart and lung function tends to improve. These are congenital deformity, so they are things that you're born with, and the two most common are the pigeon chest, where basically the chest sticks out, or the funnel chest, when you have the opposite problem, the chest sinks in. And these are two deformity that can be corrected easily by a keyhole approach. Especially the funnel chest, there is a procedure called NAS procedure, which consists in putting a bar, a stainless steel bar, across the chest to raise the sunken bit of the chest. In the past, we were taught that this is a procedure just for children, but actually this is not true. And my oldest patient was 63 and had a very good results. Yes, of course, you have to have a special expertise, because the technique is slightly different from the technique that you adopt in children, where because children have a lot more flexibility in their rib cage. The adults are a lot stiffer, so you got to have some technical expertise, but can still be done with very, very good result. Similarly, there is a procedure that can be done to correct the pigeon chest. It's called Abramson procedure, and in young patients, well, they still have quite a lot of elasticity in their chest, you don't need any surgery at all. You can put a brace on and correct the deformity over a period of about a year. It depends, because kids, as I said, have quite elastic rib cage, and usually they tolerate the procedure well. Adults tend to be a bit more in pain, but now have developed a very good combination of drugs to keep pains under control, and even more adult patients usually stay in for maybe 2-3 days on average. And then they can go back to their normal activity within few weeks. Patients have usually, sometimes these patients are completely asymptomatic and are only bothered by the appearance of the chest. But remember, then there is a recent study in the medical literature that compare patients with pectus excavatum, so the funnel chest, versus normal control, okay? And these patients have a reduced heart and lung function when you compare, as I said, to the normal control. And this is very interesting, because sometimes patient comes to me and they say, "I never managed to play sport," or, you know, "I always suffer the school," and this might be the reason. So the minute you correct their deformity, they get better, they get fitter. Or some patients complain of a lot of chest pain, and again you correct the defect, they get better. And some also are they're desperate, because, you know, they struggle to find a partner, they don't want to go, if they are kids at school, don't want to do physical exercise, don't want to go to the swimming pool, they have affects their lives considerably. And, you know, with the procedure that lasts just over half an hour, you can change their life. A especially adults, tend to be in quite a lot of pain. So therefore, we tend to prescribe a good amount of painkiller to keep pains under control. And usually, patients will have to keep this for a few weeks, usually about 4 to 6 weeks. Kids tend to do a bit better because, again, chest wall is a lot more flexible, and normally it reshapes better than in adult, and they can get away with maybe just a couple of weeks of painkiller only. But yes, this is the main problem with this type of surgery. Actually, I've noticed, especially in adults, this is not just a problem of correcting the chest wall deformity. This is basically reshaping the way the chest moves and works. And therefore, I send all my patients for physiotherapy and those postural physiotherapy, because really, you got these patients that have been, as I said, bullied and very much aware of their condition for all their life, and they tend to have this hunched posture, and the minute you correct the defect, they still maintain the bad posture. And I always tell my patient, this is not just me doing the surgery, this is a journey that we start together with the surgery, and we last 2 or 3 years until we remove the bar. And during those 2-3 years, we try to make your chest to function better. And sometimes patient after surgery came back to me after 2-3 weeks, and they said, oh, you know what, the chest is great, I'm really, really, really happy, but I have got back pain. And the reason they got back pain is most of the time because they started to use muscle that they never use in their life, and therefore the muscle tends to fatigue. So what we do, we put some tapes around along their back, so every time they assume the wrong posture, they have to straighten up because they are aware because the tape pulls at the back, and so they stand up, and eventually we get them to strengthen those muscles and make the entire chest to work better.